Detective Palmer says he conducted his investigation professionally.
And Paula Thompson says he didn't.
I spoke to Ms. Thompson.
Yeah, I heard.
I have no reason to doubt her version of events.
Neither do I.
But I also have no reason to doubt Detective Palmer.
Did you speak with any of the other victims who dealt with this guy?
The nature of these crimes prevents me from going down that road.
In other words, it's a case of he said, she said, and oh, what do you know? He wins.
If you're suggesting that a male cannot work effectively in special victims, I have thousands of made cases that say otherwise.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but your detail's out front and you're running 15 behind.
Nobody is saying that a man can't be a good SVU investigator, but he sure as hell starts with a disadvantage.
Namely?
He's not a woman.
Few men are. Baker, please, wait. Come in for a second.
I think I got the gist.
You take this to its logical extreme. It means that every victim is entitled to an investigating detective who is a gender, racial, ethnic, whatever else you have, match.
Which is impossible.
This is a police department, not a college faculty.
But, except.
Really?
Yes. There is plenty of good research, not to mention common sense, that says that the female victim in these cases may not be as candid in opening up to a male detective, and that the male detective may be hardwired with an empathy gap.
Hey, we got a whole lot of made cases from male detectives.
Because you have great cops who work hard to overcome those obstacles. But there are always exceptions.
The detective in question seemed absolutely transparent when I talked to him, Baker.
The detective was being interviewed by the police commissioner. Pretty much defines the term on his best behavior.
Good point. Thank you for reminding me.
The real test is that detective's behavior in interviewing a victim of sexual assault.
Your sense is what?
Well, I'm not sure. I wasn't in the room. But I do think that you need to follow up